Hi friends, I'm Sumati here. Today we're going to discuss biosphere that is related to environmental science. It's going to be useful for the people who are preparing for KS and IAS and other competitive exams. Do like my videos and subscribe my channel. That will be that will give a lot of updates on your related subjects. Without wasting much time, let us get into today's topic: plants, animals, and humans. It's related to biogeography. As we all know very well, earth phenomena are two types. There are living and non-living. In the two, there are several ecosystems. In the living, there are seven ecosystems, and in the non-living, there are four ecosystems. How an individual organism of the living organism interacts with the environment can be understood through the study of biogeography. It is almost 1,000 million years since life forms appeared on the surface of the earth. The first organism begins their life in the seas. Land organisms appeared soon afterwards. In occurrence of time, almost 3 million, that is 3 into 10 to the power of 6, plants, animals, and microorganisms came into existence. Presently, 1.0 million animals and 0.5 million plants have been identified and classified. There are yet several organisms that have not been classified. These living organisms are unevenly distributed on the surface of the earth. Each of the ecosystem consists of its own flora and fauna. If these were not living on earth, the earth would have been a sterile planet. So, biosphere, land, water, and wind are the three natural ecosystem of spheres. They are of solid, liquid, and gaseous forms. They may be called the non-living. Beside these, there is a fourth sphere consisting of the flora and fauna. This is called the biosphere. This may be alternatively called the living systems. Between the living and the non-living system, there are various interactions. Several environmental changes occur on the earth in response to these interactions. Place is an important concept in geography. People are the most characteristic component of the place. Hence, of all ecosystems, human ecosystems have greater importance and value. It is for the reason this ecosystem is shown at the top of all the ecosystems, and all the even ecosystems of the living things in the reverse order, and the ecosystems 1 to 4 of the non-living things be studied under the physical geography. I have given the figure here, ecosystems, under that human ecosystem, social systems, natural system, human, animals. Animals is called fauna and plants is called flora. Self-regulating systems, other than that, biological word, that is control system, process systems, cascade system, and morphological systems. Non-living system also. So let us get into plants and green potentials. The millions of plants on the earth, from very, very basis of survival of all the other life forms, it was primarily the plant life of several million years ago that gathered the oxygen in the atmosphere for several years for survival. It is held among the botanists that the destruction of the plant species is like extinguishingly 30 animal species. There are innumerable plant species that alter their lives in accordance with the environments around them. For example, there are luxuriously growing plants from the deserts to the tundra of the poles. The development of vegetation has a range of xerophytic plants of the desert, wastes of the abundantly evergreen trees of tropics. With the human interventions, the vegetation has been affected in several places. Of the total land area of the world, 30% is occurred by the forest, and these forests are fundamental cause for biological activities, biomes, and plant nutrition. They also determine the natural and magnitudes of the bio geochemical cycles such as the carbon nitrogen oxygen cycles. Further, they determine the temperature, rainfall and other climatical elements of the earth. So plants and animals, the biomes, the plants and animals communities of the biomes living in a particular territory is called the biomes. These biomes adapt themselves to prevailing environmental conditions of the surroundings. The biomes help us with a clear understanding that we require of the relationship among the ecosystem. Let us now see the interactions and relationship among the climate, soil, vegetation, animal and humankind based on the structural characteristics. The biome can be classified as follows. So forest biomes is a coniferous forest and temperate forest, tropical forest. The grassland biomes, the temperate grassland and the tropical grassland. Next one, desert biomes, cold desert and tropical desert. The last one is mountain biomes. The forest biome is a coniferous forest biomes. Taiga is the coniferous forest biome lying next to the tundra region of the northern hemisphere. These biomes seem extended across North America and Eurasia in the wild best short summer and long winters characteristics this biome region. Conducive temperatures for the growth of the plants are found in the strength of 4 to 5 months only. In summer, there is a little rain. There are highly acidic podocal soil in this region. Pyramidical trees with needle-like leaves are special features. So coniferous forest means you will find lot of the trees like needle-like leaves of the special features of the biome. Immense colonies of same species are commonly found here. As there is a plenty of food and protection, the biome is rich in flora and fauna. Caribou and rodents are in the abundance. Foxes and animals which live around these places are foxes and minks are the breed and brought up by the people. Woodpeckers and the grosbeaks and the birds that leave the heartbout. The birds migrate from the southern region and leave here in a spring and leave here only in a winter. However, the animal have the furs and could stand serve cold. The red cross bills that leaves here as a strong beak that could break the hardest of their nuts to get the kernel. In the several climatic conditions here, humans are the unable to leave naturally. Further, this region is far away from other regions of the world. Therefore, a vast expanse of several thousands of square kilometers remain uninhabited. The tribes here have hunting and fishing as the most important activities. Next one is temperate deciduous forest biome. This biome is found along with the western and the eastern continental margin of the mid-altitude. This biome is found in both the hemisphere. However, it is seen in the vast area in the northern hemisphere. It is the areas such as those of the eastern United States, southern Chile and southern East Australia, Tasmania and New Zealand. Here is the winter is mildly warmer and summer is mildly hot. The annual rainfall is regular and high. It is here brownish forest soils are found. Some of the information I would leave. Tundra biomes, it covers of 11% of the world area found in subpoetal areas, and temperate biomes, this accounts for the 9% of area. Coniferous trees and deciduous trees are found in mix. Savanna biomes account for 11% of the world geographical area. Trees in interspread with the grass and desert biome covers 25%. Desert biomes covers 25% of the world geographical area, and tropical biomes it covers 20% of the world area. In this forest here, here Trees grow tall, they shed their leaves in the months of January and February. It is the for this reason the forests here are known as the deciduous forest. So deciduous forest feature is the trees are very tall and forest. The oak and the malpa and peach that grow here have broad leaves and thick stem. In the European region, the tree bears oxen, wolves and foxes, pigs and wild cats, beside other small animals are seen. In the American deciduous forest, there are lives deer, bear and panther, red fox and squirrel. These animals to avoid the cold during the winter to into a hibernations, therefore they gather food and store them for the winter much before the cold begins. The deciduous forests are not as widespread in the southwest southern hemisphere as they are in the northern hemisphere. In the forest of Chile, the preacher or the dominated in Australia and New Zealand, and there are unique plants and animals. Except for the forest of the Mediterranean, the other forest biomes of this variety elsewhere are being changed much by the human. In Eurasia, this biome is the target for human settlement. The prevalent environment here is conducive to human life and living. Therefore, a large number of people live here. They are engaged in fishing, mining, timbering, and industrial activities. In recent times, these areas have been occupied by human and have been converted into settlement and dairy farms. Next one is tropical biome. This includes of rainforest and equatorial region and the tropical deciduous forest. The tropical rainforest are found in Amazon and Congo Valley, East Indies, India and Myanmar. In this equatorial region of high temperature and high rain, there is a profuse tree growth. These supply oxygen to the atmosphere in large quantities. In these forests, there are three bushy plants and creepers and parasites and epiphytes and hundreds and thousands of other species. The vegetation is organized in a way suitable to high temperature and heavy rainfall of the region. To get at the sunshine, the tree grow tall. To help with the high evaporation, the leaves are broad with a wide pores. The stems of the trees are propped up the arenal roots. As the tropical rainforests are thick, there are marshes and reptiles and the other animals shows characteristics tropical of the environments. And as it is difficult to move abroad about through the thick forest, large animals, leaves and edges of these forests in the thick forest. There are innumerable insects and furless animals. Further, they live on their lives for the fruits and forests. For example, the gorilla and monkeys and leopards live on these or they found in the mangroves. In the islands of Malaysia and Philippines and the East Indies, these forests have been cleared and plantations crop are grown. Rubber in Malaysia and cocoa in Africa and South America are grown in these areas. Grassland biome. These temperate grassland biomes in mid altitude. These biomes are in a continual interior. The biomes include the plants of North America, steppe of Eurasia and Manchuria plains, and Argentina Pampas, Africa Wells and Australian Downs. In certain places in these areas, the temperature is below the dew point. It is extremely cold during the winter and high temperatures during the summer. In the southern hemisphere, there is a mild cold in Argentina, with the exception of the Pampas. In other areas, there is rainfall and light. The soil of a grassland have a intimate relationship. There is a black soil with a rich plant nutrient. There are numerous grazing animals, squirrel and dog, wolves and foxes, and forest animals like leopard, and very many insects are found here. The animals that require special mentions are kangaroos, Australia, zebra of South Africa, Wild horses of Eurasia, bisons of North America, and so on. These grasslands are of economic importance. The natural biomes of the area have been changed and new ones have been developed by the human. The tribes of grasslands were engaged in the life of nomads. And later, the Eurasians have changed these grasslands into cattle farms and grazing land in their big way. They have followed crop cultivation in the fertile Chernozem. In course of time, the industrializations of the cropped land occurred. Next one is tropical grassland biome. This is also known as the savanna. The African savanna, Australian savanna, and the South American campus are included in these grassland biomes. The climate is characteristic by high temperatures throughout the year and summer rains. There are three seasons, namely cold dry season, hot dry season, and temperate rain season. The sandy dry gravel soil is found here in the African savanna. There is a wild variety of wild animals, and particularly African elephants and rhinoceros and hippopotamuses and lions are the common elements. The impact of human activities in in this biome, the Bushman and the Kirghiz are big time hunters. As the hunting was followed by even the modern people, the big animals like the elephants have become nearly extinct. In these grasslands, shifting cultivation is still largely followed to grow millets, groundnut, and pepper. In East Africa, the plantation crops were introduced by the European, example coffee, cotton, and tobacco. Desert biome is the next topic. Desert has an intimate relations with the quantum of the rainfall. They are rain deficient region. They are found in an area with a less than 250 mm of rainfall in a year. Deserts are the several types. Using moisture content, they may be classified as arid and semi-arid desert, hot and cold deserts. All these deserts have similar basic characteristics. They all have a scanty dust throughout the year. And the cold deserts biome, the cold deserts are the northern hemisphere around the people of continuous stretch. In North America, they stretch from Alaska until Labrador, and then until the edge of Greenland and Eurasia. These are found from the Scandinavia and eastern fringe of Siberia in the southern hemisphere. However, there are seas instead of tundra. In tundra, there are hills and highlands together, the gentle undulating plains. In the long winter, it is covered with snow for almost 7 long months. For many weeks or months, the sun does not shine here due to this is the high pressure characteristics with extreme cold and dry winter conditions. The annual rainfall is highly small. In winter, the soil is frozen. When the sun begins to shine, the snow begins to melt. The melting water does not infiltrate the soil, rather forms the lakes. The tundra vegetation varies from the place to place. In summer, these are grasses, lichens, and mosses and short plants. Although the flora is few in number, there is a great variety of animals, and most animals are herbivores and migratory, and caribou, reindeer, musk oxen, and polar rabbits and foxes are some of the cold desert animals. Lemmings live here through the year. The rabbits and foxes change their color to pure white during the winter, and the musk oxen have skins with a gray furs. Lemmings have a strange lifestyles. They breed fairly rapidly and multiply to the great numbers in about 3 years. This done, the armies of lemmings travel towards the sea. They travel by night until they reach the sea. Then they swim through the water until they die. These parts conditions conducive for the human living are but a few. In North America, Eskimos are people of small numbers that depend mostly on the sea biomes for the food for their food. Laps on the erosion lands move south during the winter, although their movement are increasingly being restricted to certain pockets, and they get most of their food needs and satisfied with the milk and meat and their clothing from the skin and reindeer. Hot desert. Most important of the hot deserts are Sahara and its extensions. This are Arabian deserts. They are Kalahari. The West Australian deserts, Atacama and California deserts are the other hot deserts. The plants of these deserts are able to withstand the dryness. They are so structured as to adapt to the conditions. Narrow leaves and chlorofluorine rich stems, deep and penetrating roots and protective spikes and small thorns are the characteristic features. The plants are spaced out because of the scarce groundwater sources. In the desert, like the plants, the animals are also limited in number. They are able to bear the drought and heat the deserts. Animals like the camel, mountain goats and other small animals live in the deserts. Camels drink as much as water they get when available and stay without water for a long period. Some rotten of the deserts live on the dry vegetables and fruits. Some small animals are nocturnal in their search for the food, and they stay holed up in their burrows to avoid the day temperature. Smaller insects have wax coating to protect them from the heat. People are sparsely distributed in the desert, and they do not stay permanently in the place but lead nomadic life. We find some of the desert tribes in the descent even today. Mountain biomes is the next final topic. Apart from the great biomes above, there are maintained biomes, mountain biomes, which differs in their characteristics in accordance with the changing temperature regimes. In the Rockies of North America, the Andes of South America, and the Alps of Europe, and the Himalayas of Asia consist of biomes so far distributed in the respective characteristic zone of the mountain. Harvesting forest. As the forest products the commercial in nature, they have global commercial potential. They are on the increase as well. Japan and the West European countries import timber products in a very large quantities. Timber industry is likely to grow according to the exports to 6 billion trees from the present 3 billion trees. In the developed countries, 200 million tons of wood pulp in produced. As the literacy is increasing in the developing countries, there is a greater use of newsprint in countries like Brazil and India. The use of newsprint has already doubled. As hardwood is required for the industrial purpose, it is mostly obtained from the tropical forest. Wood is exported in a great quantities from the Southeast Asian countries. In these countries, more than half the tree is the forest and have been filled for this purpose. Only in recent times, the government of these countries have taken efforts towards the preventing the destructions of the forest. Shrinking forest. 12 million hectares of forest are being cut every year for by use of human being. The areas of usual forest destruction is estimated at the area which is as big as the United Kingdom. The fast declining forest are brought in charge in the functions of ecosystem are fast being destroyed for meeting the needs of the humankind can be replaced in about 10 years. On the contrary, the areas of deforestation used by humans for agriculture and settlement user in charge in the ecosystems configurations. Problems. If the vegetation system at the watershed areas are destroyed, they give rise to several problems. As long as the forest in these areas survive, the water of the rivers could be pure and clear. But as we destroy the forest and there are areas, there could be a flood and droughts in the low reaches. Furthermore, as a result of soil erosions along the slopes, there is a siltations in the flood plains, with the siltation dams where the hydroelectricity is produced and fishing and greatly affected. With the destructions of the tropical forest, the climate is also impact upon the forest ecosystems of Amazon, absorbs most of the solar radiation and it is destroyed. Progressively, the area heated up by the radiation, which turn heats and atmosphere and affects the atmosphere equilibrium. This is thus reasons for a global warming and the forest management. Tropical and temperate ecosystems consist of different biomes. As such, the managerial strategies must differ as well. To protect the ecosystems, the following strategies are being followed: renewal of the watershed, social forestry and sustainable systems. Renewal of watershed is the several countries of the world have come to realize the importance of the forest. In response, they have begun to renew the forest of the watersheds. But such efforts are few and small scales. It is expected that such strategies would become widespread. Next one is social forestry. And social forestry is internationally, such a forests have been welcomed in several countries. The government have these countries motivate their people to grow social forestry to meet the needs of fuel wood. In India, in several states of union, and so school children grow trees under these program. Sustainable systems, agroforests have become in many places sustaining systems. In this forest, crops and trees are grown side by side. Unutilized forest areas and the field edges have now become important resources for increasing crop productivity, and particularly tree varieties help to fix nitrogen in the soil. As a consequence, lands of low quality are turned into the lands and could be utilized for the cropping. So sea ecosystems of the planets of the solar systems, the earth we live is in alone have as a water in plenty. Nearly 97% of the all water areas in the seas, there are the seas and oceans are reservoir of heat. Therefore, the seas are generally hot in summer and cold in winter of the solar heat reaching the earth, and fourth in used in evaporating the sea. The sea surface temperatures vary from place to place. The equatorial region, it is a high and it progressively low, and we go from equator to the poles. In the sea water, there is a high concentrations of mineral salts and salinity. Salinity also differs from the place to place. The ratio of the salinity depends upon the addition of fresh water in the sea and the rate of evaporations. Waves, tides and current or the movement of the ocean waters, they influence the temperature, moisture and rainfall of the coastal areas. They flow to cold current brings with them the plant cones from the poles and the subpolar regions. The mixing of warm and cold current helps with the proliferations of the ocean and sea organisms along the continental shelves. You are already aware that the living organism appears first in the area seas. The vegetations and animals of the seas are quite different from the flora and fauna and land. They live in the continental marginal island and in the deep seas. Among the sea ecosystem, there are four major and very important ecosystem useful of humankind. They are the wild wetlands, the marshes and the estuaries and the coral reef, and temperate tidal land becomes the wetlands and the tropical tidal land becomes the marshes. In these lands, the sea grasses and the flowering plants are abundantly seen. These plants are consumed as food by the shellfish and shrimp. They are the food store for the temperate Greece and the Flamingos. Further, they are filter for the vast wastes from the land and prevent sea erosions along the coastal. As the fish and brackish waters, fresh and brackish waters meet at the estuaries, these waters are conducive environment for crabs and ostriches. Prawns and shellfish. This is the estuaries are suitable environment for sea organisms and of the sea ecosystem, one of the coral reef. There are several different organisms living in the with them, and these are also in an ancient of the ecosystem. Coral have existent from the very beginning of the sea life. Before growing of the colonies, they generate chemical products and expand their areas of colonizations with the metamorphosis of the chemical products. Other organisms are usual to colonize these areas to provide the resistance to the disease and causing germs, and human use them as a raw materials for the medicines. The corals leaving colonies, and they are the collective. They are microorganisms leaving shells known as the polyps. The polyps are made up of calcium and extended from the sea by the corals. The corals are stuck together and leave one massive organism, even though they are the such tiny creature. The substance that fasten them is produced by the coral themselves. Corals lives only in the tropical seas. They cannot survive in water with the temperatures below 20% Celsius, 20 degree Celsius. Hence, they are not found in the areas of high altitude temperature region. They are normally found between 30 degree north and 30 degree south altitude. The food and the warmth they require and obtain them ocean currents like the planets. They require sunshine as well. So they are found beneath the sea waters, but only until where the sun's rays and penetrations and where the temperature warms enough for their comforts. Waves and however hamper their growth, it is for the reason they are found growing along the coast, hanging to the land. The wave cut platforms provide for a place for the corals to attach to. Coral are the three types. They are fringing reef and the barrier reef and atoll. In the southern sea of India, we have a fringing reefs, and the Lakshadweep islands are entirely made up of coral. And in Caribbean also, there are coral island. Right along the east coastal of Australia, there is a Great Barrier Reef, and stretching for thousands of kilometers, there are now tourist and recreation spots, and tourists flock these places in large numbers to see the colorful variety of sea animals around the reefs. And there are therefore diving facility in these regions. Our tools are the complex coral reef and raised around the island by the coral colonies over thousands of years. In between, there is a shallow lagoon. In this atolls, the coral get exposed as the water in lagoon goes down. Atolls, it is said, have a fascinating origin. Apart from these sea organisms, there are several other plankton, nekton and benthon. The floating microorganisms are normally known as planktons, and with the movement of seas, the planktons migrates along the current, and ocean diatom is a plankton with a single cell, and nektons are swimming organisms. Fish, whales and seals are nektons, and majority of the sea animals migrate for food and breeding. The mammalian seas are the restless animal moving hector and thither. Some of the whales migrate from cold waters into warm water. Algae are the sea mosses seen on the surface of the sea waters on the country. Those that are found beneath the sea surface are benthos. In these, there are moving and non-moving creatures. For example, large sea crabs and shells, starfish and worms are the moving creatures. Sea planets, seaweeds and mosses, coral, ostriches and sea forms and non-moving varieties. Benthos living in areas where the sun penetration deep into the water. They are also found in deep oceans in the certain areas. The sea organism describes about above or some way useful to the human consumers commodities such as a cosmetic, shampoos, dyes and lubricants are all manufactured using sea organic raw material. At the same time, the oceans and seas are being polluted by the human activities. The water from the cities, industries, atomic reactors and oil refinery are being dumped into the sea along the coast, causing concern in the pollutions. The pollutants from these affects the sea organism and also destroy them. If we do not control the pollutions, the oceans have the living seas maybe one day become the dead seas. So with this I'll be stopping today's lesson, and I hope this lesson is helpful for you guys. And do like my videos, and before that I'll leave some of the question answers here and dashes. That will be helpful for you to revise your learning. So let us see what are the question and answers and the dashes that will be helpful for you. Microorganisms that floats in the sea dash. The organism that swims and belongs to the species of whale is dash. Coniferous forests are dash biomes. Dash is the temperature grassland biome. Dash is the world ocean ecosystems. And choose the correct answers. I have given you the choices. And next one is brief answers. Biomes, nictons and benthons, coral relief and estuaries. Write a brief answer for all these topics. And write a paragraph answers for the wetlands and marshy lands, temperate grassland biome and cold deserts biome and trophic biomes. And next one is detailed answer for the classify the types of biome and explain any one in detail. What are the forest products? Explain the strategy to be followed to protect the forest. And what is mean by coral? What are its type? And discuss about the biome in your area. List type of biome and describe in short. And prepare a scrapbook with a picture of a sea organism. Draw the biome of the grassland and the world map and color them. And I hope this class is helpful for you guys. Do like my videos and subscribe my channel for more updates. Thank you. Have a great day. Bye.